Hi, everybody. This is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat. And if you haven't seen it, you can check back through my videos and see where I showcased a couple of digital kits that Meg from Meg's Garden of Papercraft on Etsy, she gifted me. And so I hadn't had a chance to really play with them other than to just show you what was there. So I have Sepia Flowers and Apricot Blush. And I kind of just combined the two kits together. So I'm not sure which is which, but you can check out her Etsy shop. I'll put the link below the video if you're interested in getting them. And as I said, this is a digital download. Yeah, you don't get anything physical. You order it, download it to your computer, and print it or have it printed. But I wanted to make some cards with this because I just loved it. So I took minor 5x7 cards. I took one of the papers, and I just cut it 10x7 to make a 5x7 card. I see I have not inked it yet, so I'm going to quickly do that. I like to ink inside and out. I have a little spot here, but I'll figure out something to hide that. So on the front of my card, I took another piece from her collection, and this is a little heavier weight, and I'm just going to put it here in the front. This is like a quarter of an inch below the 5x7. So 6¾, and you can see I goobered on the back. 6¾ by, let's see, 4¾. And I found out that sometimes on the lighter weight cardstock, if I don't get rid of my lines with the glue, then I'll have lines showing on the reverse side, and I can't handle that. So I have taken my art glitter glue and put it into one of those sugar bell bottles, which is great because it comes out much better, but it also comes out thicker. So with that, you have to realize that if your glue is thicker, you may get the lines. Let me get this down and then I'll show you. You may get the lines on this side, the swirl lines from the glue, and I can't stand that. So I just take an old credit card or hotel card or whatever and just smooth it out, and that seems to work. Now I have some music paper here. I'm going to quickly ink that because it doesn't look like I did it. I also have garbage day. Sorry, you're hearing the garbage trucks outside and it's so noisy. Even though I'm upstairs and my window is just a smidgen open, it still sounds like they're coming right through my craft room. Anyway, this is an old dictionary that I picked up at the used bookstore. And I have a panel here that I colored with some sprays and then ran through an embossing folder. That's going to go here in the front. But I want some interest underneath it. So I thought I would put a little piece of this has to go this way, that's the right way up, music paper under it, and some of the dictionary paper up in the other corner like that. Let's just glue those down and see. I'll just put a little here in case I get desperate and want to change my mind. I can always come back and add some more glue after the fact. But it's kind of hard to lift things up. Oh, like I'd ever change my mind, duh. But you know what it's like. You put something down and then you think, oh, I wish I had put it there. So, okay, so there's that one. I think those are the only two things that go underneath. So I can probably be safe by gluing this down. I like how the paper looks. This is just something I found in my stash that I had been playing with that was sitting there with the distress inks. And that's what I've been trying to do, is use up things that I was playing with or practicing with into, that's not straight there. Let's see. That's better. There we go. And it pretty much matches the colors. This is all for the inside, so let's get rid of that and all these little dingly danglies. Okay, so I have this one. Isn't that just gorgeous image. Just love it. I haven't inked around it, but I'm seeing some white where I fussy cut it that maybe I want to get rid of. And I don't mind that when I ink around it, I get the shadow of the brown. I just like that. That is a vintage photo in the distress oxide that I'm using. I'm just trying to see if there's an up and a down. And I kind of want this right here. So I'm just going to put glue in the middle for now, because that gives me the option to maybe pick it up and move it if I change my mind. I didn't take a picture of this. I was going to, so I knew what was what. But I did want to, oh, I have this piece that I did want to kind of layer underneath here like that. And then I have this one, and come on, off of there, and this one. So this one had an arch at the top, and I cut it off. Don't be afraid to cut your pieces. And you can see, I wanted to show you what I had done, so I just took a pencil and drew around where these little petals are going to go. So now I can actually glue them down. I did ink around this, but I used the new Kurt's Flamingo, Kit's Flamingo, however it said. And I'm just going to put some glue on there. And then this is going to go, let's see, like this. Because I knew I would never find where I wanted that again. And I wanted the 12 at the top. And I kind of wanted to be able to bring this to the front. That's why I split it and put this piece on top of the other like that. So be sure and cut your stuff up. You don't have to use it just the way it is. I want this part to go clear to the top and see where the straight edge is. I want it right over here to the edge like that. So I'm just going to put some glue here. And I'm going to put some glue here. And I'm pretty well going to leave the rest free until I figure out for sure where I want the rest of the stuff. So we know we want this up here, and we know we want this over here like this, like that. And my 12 o'clock is pretty well, let's see, pretty well lined up. I don't have to have it perfect. Don't have to have it perfect, Patty. But it's so hard not to. Okay, so now I want to kind of slide this little piece, yeah, like that, underneath. If you can find a used dictionary, an old one, that is just great. We had one when I was growing up that had can't talk and press down at the same time, guys. It had the little letters indented down the side of it. Oh, that was cool. You know, but who would save a dictionary? I don't have any idea where it went. You know how it is. You wish you had everything you had when you were a kid, but my goodness, where would you put all that stuff? See, I like this because it kind of pulls it through, so I think I have this for the inside, but that's okay. I have a lot more of this. I'm going to sneak it right underneath here so I don't see that edge, but it's right. Kind of brings this one and this one together. There we go. And now I have some of these threads. These threads are just the ends off of my sewing machine when I've been sewing. I should refrain that. I guess I don't sew anymore, but when I'm sewing around the edge of my mats or anything, I put all of the threads into a little jar and save them just to put back here. Okay. So let's go ahead and glue this down and get those threads out of there. I pushed them up, I think, like that. Like that. Do, 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 do. Oh, I like how that looks. And then I kind of want them to slide down underneath here, too. So I'm going to very gently lift these pieces up here. This one. This one. And definitely this little one right here, because it's kind of fragile and I need to get it underneath so that, and glued down so that it doesn't get torn in the, come on, I think it's supposed to go, there we go, like that. There we go. Thought I had my, yep, let's do the tweezers, that's better. All right. So I'm really liking how that looks. I kind of want some kind of word or something up here, but isn't that, oh, or you know where it would be really pretty would be around here. I need to find something for right there, so I have to look for that. And since I don't have anything out here, I'll probably have to pause you for a minute while I go hunting. Because, boy, I have a hard time making up my mind of what I want. But I'm just going back now and gluing down the spots that I just had kind of tacked down before. Oh, I like how that looks. All right. And I need some right there because that's coming up. Now, on the inside, I had these that I think they were the remnants of that. And so I thought I'm going to put it across the bottom like there, but I thought I'd just kind of make a cluster to match the front. So I have a piece of the dictionary paper, a piece of the music paper. I'm going to put this stuff here. So let's just put some glue down. I was going to put this all together, but then I thought, well, maybe some of you have not seen me make my clusters, and it's nothing that everybody else doesn't do. But in case you haven't done this, these are so fun to do. You can use up your scraps, and you have a really interesting focal point underneath. Okay, I have a couple pieces from the paper line, and I think I want to put that one on this end like this. I tore that so that it would be the same width as the bottom of my card. And I know a lot of you probably don't put anything on the inside of your cards, but let me tell you a little secret. Once you start putting stuff on the inside of your card is never ever going to look finished to you again if you don't have something on the inside of that sucker. I don't know. I just can't seem to do it without without putting something on there. Yeah, let's see. Like this, I guess. No, I think I had that underneath like that with that over the top of it. And I think what I'm going to do is maybe tear it off of this side. Well, let's put it down first and then I can tear it off. I wanted to slide this part that I had torn underneath the music paper. So it's kind of tucked in there. But when I do that, now it's going to make it too long on this side. So I'm just not even going to look at the front. I'm going to reach back there and tear it and then put some ink over the top. And then we'll have this. And I'm just going to put it right down here. Now, the reason I use the paper, and this is not, I'll link underneath the paper that I buy from Amazon that I print my digitals on. It's a Nina paper. It's not exceedingly heavy like heavyweight cardstock by any means. And normally, I would never use it for a card base, but I'm trying so hard to make my cards so that they only require one stamp when I put them out in the mail, because otherwise I might as well mail them a book because it costs so much. And I heard that postage was going up here again in the U.S. so it's going to cost even that much more. Okay, so this is this one, but before I quit here, I think I'd like to take my pen, and I think I just like to pretend I could have taken this over to the sewing machine and stitched it, but I really like how it looks when you just take your pen and you go across the top of stuff and under the bottom of stuff, and you just draw a line, and I'll show you in a minute how I'm going to finish it off here. You just draw a line, and this is going to be a pretend stitching line like I stitched it. And we're going to go down here. I'm going over the papers that I added, and then I'm going to just do a little ziggity-zaggity here somewhere that makes it look like I had scrunched up a bunch of, I like that. To me, that finishes it off. Just really like it. And now I will do an envelope as well that coordinates with this. I'm going to hunt for a word off camera and I'll come on and show you. But let's go ahead and do another one that I have sitting here so you can see. We'll set that one to the side. I have this one. This is another one of the backgrounds. And I have inked it inside and out. Looks like it needs just a little bit more here. Inside and out. And then I have this really lovely paper that I thought just complemented this to no end. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? And I have, let's see, now I have to figure out which one goes in the front and which one. This is the front. I have this piece of paper. Look at this. Oops. Yep. This goes in the front like this. And this goes on the inside. So let's just slide that inside so I don't try gluing it down somewhere. So I'm going to put this down first because I don't think I'm going to put anything underneath this one. And the same thing. Because I'm using those Sugar Bell bottles and the nibs are bigger, I'm going to use my little card just to spread my glue out so that I don't get any big lines of glue. Now, the only thing you have to remember with the art glitter glue, it dries really fast. So don't spend a lot of time doing that or you're not going to be able to glue it down because it's going to have glued. The glue is going to have set up. I'll get the spit out here in a minute. Okay. Now I debated whether I wanted to just run this panel from the inside here from where my mat is. But I decided I really wanted to do it from the top to the bottom. And it looks like I still might have to trim just a little bit. I'm going to go across the bottom here and I'm going in a little ways because then it will land on this paper and I won't have to worry about any bubbles or anything. So I want this flush. So I'm going to bring it up like that. Make sure it's right at the edge and then press it down really good. And I've left it up here in case I want to put stuff under it. And as you can see, I'm off just a little, so I'm just going to trim that off. This is the most gorgeous paper to make cards with I've ever seen. And some of my colors, you'll see if you go back and look at the where I shared the kit with you. My printer setting was off, so some of them are definitely not what it should have been. Okay, here's, they're more pinker. So I printed them twice. So if these look pinker to you, it's the, I had it on Vivid and Vivid didn't like it. It complained. So here's one of the pieces from the paper that I just tore around. Here is, I don't know where these are at. These are like a doily, but they're kind of, waffly on the inside. I don't know how to explain it. So I kind of wanted this to be my focal point. And then I have these little gals. And I wanted them to go down here. And I have a butterfly and a number. Well, I had a number somewhere. I'll have to hunt for the number. I don't know what happened to it. And maybe it's still on the inside here. Nope. Well, I'll find another number. And then I had, maybe I had these up here like this. No, I didn't. But it looks like I'm missing something and I don't know what it was. I just took a piece of this. I don't know what it is. Oh, I know. I'm going to put that on here. Duh. Okay, so I have a piece of double-sided tape. Come on, off of there. There we go. On the back of this little goodie. And I'm just going to take it here. And I'm going to take it here. And then I'm just going to kind of push it in the middle. So what I'm getting is a little bit of gathering on this side. And these are going to go, come on, don't tear on me. These are going to go like this. Like that. wonder if I wanted that the other way. No, because that's my length. So let's just do this again because I think it's too long. I can always cut it off. That's no biggie. But let's just do this and see if I like that better. I think I like that better. Okay, I'm going to put that. I'm going to put this. And I want, don't want, and this will still have to be torn. So let's do that. I wonder if I can tear it. Oh, yeah. I want to tear it because if you tear it, you get those messy pulled threads and uneven edges and everything. And that's what I want. And I just took my, ink pad down on it to give it a little bit. Let's pull some of this out so that it's a little bit more tattered and frayed and not so perfect. I don't want perfect. I want, there we go. I want rattiness. Rattiness, isn't that a word? Okay, so I've got that there, and I have that there, and then I have my ladies. They're going to come right, like right here. Oh, I like them. So let's put some glue right here and put another little piece there and put these together. And I'll put this here. I just used some oxide sprays on this to give it the color I wanted. That looks good. And then we can do this. And we've got several layers here, so I don't have to worry about my glue showing on the back side because and we have these ladies. And see, I love that this says Find Joy in the Ordinary. I thought that looked really good. Don't know quite where I want that. I think I'm going to have it like over in here in this part. So let's move. Let's put these guys down. And okay, Find Joy in the Ordinary. Wonder if I can tear this a little bit more right here and slide it underneath. I think I'll do that. Don't be afraid to tear it up. Push it in. Just make it your very own Joy in the Ordinary. I just want to make sure that I have Ordinary sticking out there like that. And maybe I want to kind of curl this a little bit. Oh yeah, I like that. This is just a chopstick. Like that. And then if I put just a tiny little bit of glue right here on the edge of that where I curled it, and I push it down, maybe my curl will stay. Oh, I like just having a little bit of movement there. I like how that looks. It just, I don't know, there's something about it. Okay, and I have another little piece of this stuff that I just ripped off over here. This one, these are the ones that I just pulled off when I was trying to make it smaller. But I think I'm going to take one of these, and I'm going to put some glue. Let's see. I'm going to do it the other way. I'm going to put my tweezers here. I'm going to put my glue here. Like this. Okay. And I'm going to just, I'm gluing my fingers, just slide that right underneath where I left that little hole there. Come on, get in there. I've got glue on my fingers, so the minute I, there we go. Just so you get a little whiff of that. Come on, don't do that. There. There. And I wondered if I could do that with some of the others too. So let's take this one. Because see, this one, this is the weirdest stuff. I don't know. It's almost like it should be a netting for a bridal veil or something. Okay, so let's turn this around and see if I can poke this little tiny piece right underneath here. So it will kind of have the illusion there that it's gone across and come out this other side. And there's not very much here, you'll see. There we go. But it just gives something up there. Okay. Oh, I like how this one looks too. Now I have a butterfly from the collection. And I kind of changed how I had everything, so I'm not sure. I think I'll kind of put the butterfly there. I wish I had another little piece of lace that I could put underneath. Just something here. This is an old piece of crochet lace. Let's see if I can rip a little piece of this off. Put it underneath and just have something. All right. Just something for my butterfly to kind of light on there. Let's see. Where do you want to go here, guy? Oh, like that. Like that. Just like that. I got glue all over my fingers. Okay, so I'm going to put glue down here. And I'm going to put glue here. Glue everywhere. And then like this. Like that. But just so we have a little bit something more underneath the butterfly to sit on. I even remembered to get my baby wipes out today before I started. Okay. So, oh, I like how that looks. I like this little string coming down here. I like find the joy in the ordinary. I like that. Okay, so let's go to the inside. And I have another one of these that I cut. That's going to go here like this. I wonder if I could use my glue stick on this. It's going to be on the inside and really won't get too much. So let's just, because with the glue stick, I'm not going to get any little lines or anything on the other side. So let's put this, oops. Let's put this right here along the side like that. Like that. So I have lots of room to make a note. I have this Created with Love that was a stamp. So I took a little piece of this paper and I'm going to put this right down here. Right down here in this corner, and I can use glue because it won't show on the other side because there's another piece of paper there. And then I'll just put my name on there too. And I don't think I did that to my last one because I have another one of these. I always like to put something on the back like this with my name next to it. So here's this one. Now, how simple was that? Yeah, half an hour and we have two done. By the time I edit some of this out, okay, I have one more sitting here to show you. This one is like a peachy pink. Here's another handmade by. And, okay, and this is the insides of this one. The innards and the back. And this is the front. Okay, so I have this really pretty green. And no, this is not in Meg's kit. It's something that I had printed out who knows where. But it was a perfect color of green. And see, it's just going to barely give me that peachy edge all the way around, which is great. Except right here, I see, might have to cut that off. I don't want it to. And see what I did? I goobered. That's why I had to put the green on, because I goobered it here, but that's okay. Because I had taken this. This is from her collection. I ran it through my embossing folder. And then I decided I would ink it, and I had it down there, and I goobered. What can I say? Okay, I have this little tag. This is from Your Creative Story, Your Creative Studio. Why do I always want to call it that? Your Creative Studio, that studio box. And I want to do this and change the colors up. So I have a green here. This is not an oxide green, but this is. This is the flamingo one, and I have that one. And then I have the vintage photo. Oh, I like that already. And then I just want to take some water just a little bit there, and spritz it, and just set that back for a minute. And let's get some little in it. Okay, so I've got this one like this. Oh, isn't that pretty? Just love it. The other thing was that I have the Empress Mini that I got as a gift, and it only, the plates were only so long, and this embossing folder cut off there. So when I cut it, it was too small. So I thought, well, I'll just mount it on that green. And then I absolutely loved how that green popped. So I'm going to just put this in the middle again. Super, super, super simple cards, people. But, oh, so pretty. And I think they will go in just a regular envelope with no problem. Now, I have this piece of that lace over there. And I thought I would put it, which way do I want? I thought I would put it like this, like that. And still, I want my embossing to show. I want to give a little bit of ink around so this stands out. I'm going to tuck that in and around like that. Oh, I love how that looks already. Now I have another piece of that that I'm going to tuck underneath. So it'll be the doily, the lace, and then this, three layers. So let's wonder if I want to maybe put just carefully, because this is so delicate. And then I think I will take my glue stick again, because maybe I can use the glue stick, and if I'm careful, not rip this and get it to go. There we go. Let's hope that's enough. All right. So about where do I want this? Right about in here. Like that. Oh yeah, that worked fine. And that will hold all those little tiny pieces. I have never used a glue stick until just this last year when I've been doing journals and watching so many people, or the glue pages or anything, use glue sticks that way. Now I'm just going to put my glue like this in different spots to try to hold this. And I want this to go over the top. The minute you put the lace on it, I just love how it looks. Okay, don't do that. Okay. Like that. Like that. Very pretty. Very pretty. And then I have this piece. I kind of want to tuck it underneath and like that. Oh, isn't that pretty? Thank you. Thank you, Meg, for sharing with me. I just love how this looks. And I'll bring it up so it catches right, so it continues to circle around. Very pretty. Like that. You have to put a little bit more glue here. And that piece of the lace was already folded and ironed. It might have even been sewn at one time. So I just left it folded over. Didn't try to undo it. Okay. A little piece of glue showing there. So I'm going to move my lace over just a little to cover that up. That looks so pretty. Let's get rid of this glue right here. And then I have, this was where I had the number piece. This is number two. And I'm going to put it on the back. And this is one of those stickers. So let's see if this will work. Where I put the tape on the back. Oh, yes, look at that. The tape on the back and the sticker just pulls off. Wow. I think G. Kerr is the one that showed how to do that. Bless her heart, because that was the worst thing about those. It was getting the backing off. Number two. Oh, I hope that's straight. To me, it looks a little crookedy. I'm going to see if I can just pull it down just a hint. There we go. Crooked or not, that's how it's going to be now. And then I have this one. Remember that one that I did with the, I don't know if it'll pick it up. It's so faint. But I wanted it to go right in here. with a word on it. So let's do the same thing. Let's take a piece of, now do I want to put just a little bit more ink around the edge here? Like this. And see if this one works as great as the last one did. Come on now. Look at that. Oh my goodness. I know I'm excited, but you guys don't know how I have sweated trying to do those. So frustrating. Okay, I'm going to put that right there like that. And then I have one of these little Timmy ones. And I found this one here that says, just a memory. And I thought, oh, I really like that. But it's too white. So I'm just going to take my ink over it. Maybe a hint of the green and a hint of the pink to bring everything in. And then I'll hold it in place, let's see, like this. And I want to put a little bit of glue on it because now that I've had my sticky fingers on it, I don't think it would stay in put. So we're going to put this across here and that. Oh, wow. Look how great that fits. Just a memory. And I have a little bit of glue, which I should probably just leave alone. But isn't that pretty? Okay, I trimmed it just a little bit. Oh, that's better. Gives me a little bit more wiggle room, and I show a little bit more of the color behind it. Oh, I just love this. A bit more at the bottom than the top, but that's all right. Oh, I just think that's so pretty. So pretty. All right. Now, for the inside, I don't know about this. I think it's too big. I'm going to have to go through my other butterflies because I just don't care for that one. All right, let's do the inside. So I have this piece. This is going to go right here like that. Like that. So let's just start building from there. So I have that one and this sagey green that was the back. And it's going to go right underneath here like that. So I just get a hint of it right there. And then I have this one that's the other piece of the paper that I was using. Oh, that was not right, Patty. Shame on you. Okay, let's see. We'll just do like this. I wanted it to be on the top, not on the bottom. All right, let's try that again. And this is way, we don't even need that much. Let's get rid of some of that. And let's do this. All right. And we're going to put it like this. Like that. Like that. And then I have another piece of this little lace. And I have this. Oh, my goodness. I love that. So this is just going to be scrunched up and go in here. Right in there like that. This is going to go over the top of it like that. But I think I'm going to need more glue. I usually use beacons when I do the lace stuff like this, not the art glitter glue. Art glitter glue holds. It's just that the beacons is so much tackier that it sticks to this kind of netting stuff better. But I'm almost out of it, and I've really been hoarding, and I should have bought it last month or the month before, but prices on everything have just gotten so outrageous. But of course, now the prices are even worse, so I don't know. You just have to do it. Now, isn't that pretty? I like that. So we're going to put that right here on the inside. So pretty. Just a little something, and let's get some glue on this, right? Right in here. And then I want glue on this. Like that. And we're going to stick it down. I'm going to go just a little tiny edge away from the away from the card base. So you just get that little hint of that white right there. Right here along the edge. Don't you think that's lovely? I just love it. And I like how this looks. This would make a beautiful sympathy card as well. I think I take the number two off. There's that one. Sympathy. Here's this one. And here's this one. Okay, I found this. It's the simple things. And it was one long one like this. And then I just cut it apart into the three. And I think I'm going to ink it up and put it there because I really, I don't know. We won't be able to see it on screen, but that little bit of pink that I put on it right here, that's cool because that pulls it all together. Now, I wondered if I could find anything here that said in life. It's a simple thing, the beauty in life. Of this life. So how about if I take this part that says of this life, okay. So let's see what we have. This is the first one. See, it's the simple things of this life. So there's that pretty one. Here's this one. Find joy in the ordinary with the three little ladies. And here's the inside. And here's this one. So pretty with the inside. So there we go. Three cards in a half an hour. Such fun. Enjoy, everyone. Have a great crafty day. Be sure and go over and check out Meg's Garden on Etsy. I'll leave the link below. She has some wonderful downloads, and she's a very sweet person, too. Okay, bye, everyone. Talk to you soon. Have a great crafty day. If you're not a subscriber, I would love for you to become one. And if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button because YouTube really likes that. Bye, everyone.